وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى In this final episode and lesson إن شاء الله تعالى Our eighth lesson and our ninth episode Which is the final and last إن شاء الله تعالى Here I want to speak about شعائر يوم العيد What are the symbols and things that we must do on the day of عيد What are the things that are required from us to do on the day of Eid? First of all, what is the sifatu takbirah? How should we say the takbirah of the day of Eid? We should say in the following way. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd. That is what we should be saying on the day of Eid. That's the takbirah. Which is the second point. When should we say it? It is legislated for us to say the takbirah for the day of Eid when the month of Ramadan is complete and it's done. So the last night of Ramadan after min ghurub al-shams when the sun sets until the night of Eid or Salatul Eid as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he said in the Qur'an وَلِتُكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةَ وَلِتُكَبِّرُوا اللَّهِ When the month of Ramadan is complete, we should do takbir for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what Allah says in the ayah, وَلِتُكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةَ وَلِتُكَبِّرُوا اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ We're showing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gratitude, that we're happy. The blessings that He has bestowed us subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is also legislated الْجَهْرُ بِهِ وَإِظْهَارُ That we say it very loud and we scream, it is highly recommended. We should say it في المساجد, in the masajid, والمنازل, in our houses, والطرقات, in the streets. We say it in every place it is permissible to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to say Him. What is also legislated, my beloved brothers and sisters, is before we go to the prayer, Salatul Eid, that we eat. Some dates, witran, odd numbers. And this is based on the hadith of Anas ibn Malik, al-Imam al-Bukhari, who narrated in his Sahih, that كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يغدو يوم الفطر حتى يأكل تمرات. That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم never used to come out on the day of Fitr, Eid al-Fitr, unless he ate some dates. And it's recommended to eat those dates, 3, 5, 7, 9 or even more, but make it odd. And last but not least, it is recommended mukhalafatul tariq, that the path that we took for the Salatul Eid, we take another path other than it. And this is based on the hadith of Jabir ibn Abdullah radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma. He said, كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا كان يوم عيد خالف الطريقة. That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was one On the day of Eid, he would go on a different road, meaning he will alternate between the roads that he took. The path that he took to the Salatul Eid would not be the path he would return from it, alayhi salatu wassalam. And then Imam al-Bukhari narrated that in his Sahih. These are the things that we must do to, inshallah ta'ala, honor Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and bring out and show the symbols of al-Islam. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.